Hey YouTube, Gundam here, welcome back to Space Engineers. The SMDC today is presenting, besides the color differential on the top there, and actually no, that stays. The SMDC is presenting their very first warship. This is a Corvette. This is the SMDC's Sparrow. So, what's this thing armed with? Well, it has two gatling gun turrets, the same as the Badger, but then it has two other weapons up front. Excuse me, not two, two on each side, so four in total. You can't forget the other side of the ship, although I just did. There is a pair of rocket launchers and a pair of light cannon turrets. Those are turrets that can be controlled, however, generally are not. They are left to the. They can be controlled by the turret operators, or they can be controlled by the main pilot. They're supposed to be controlled by the main pilots, but they can be controlled by turret operators. So, taking a look at this ship from the outside, it's not very big, actually. It definitely has reduced height compared to other ships, which we have over there. SMDC there. Here's a nice back view. This is the entirety of the forward thrusters. There's no Sage thrusters that would significantly increase the length. The whole point was to make a shorter ship. Right there, you can see it says Sparrow. Plenty of azimuth thrusters on the top, and plenty of azimuth thrusters on the bottom. You see a couple up front, there's the main bit, and there's a few in the back. The only heavy armor on this ship is these three here, and that one there. So four, because of the armored thruster right there. This permits docking purposes. And yes, you can see the primary connector is tucked into the ship. The reason for that is it's supposed to be refueled by something with a piston. The crucible has a piston in the center. It's supposed to be connected. You're supposed to connect it having the piston down and then raise it up, and the docking clamps that are in the middle will then dock onto the armor bits on the top there. So, as you can see, there's an oxygen generator, an oxygen farm inside, and this is the only way in or out of the ship. If you take a look at the other side, there's two oxygen farms on this side. So let's go into the ship. Oh, by the way, before we do, actually, this is a size comparison. Here's the Sparrow. This here is a IMDC's Hydroclass Corvette. It's quite small, but kind of chubbier. You know, it's not very long. It's about the same height. Actually, it is the same height.
Excuse me. I haven't got much sleep.
It's, quite fat, though. Sorry, it is. Now, here we have a Badger down here, and taking a look at the Badger compared to the Sparrow, the Badger is, in fact, a little longer. Not including the antenna. If the antenna were attached to the same point, the Sparrow would end about where the oxygen farm is. So the Sparrow is shorter. We're going to go ahead and go into the ship now. Head in through the primary airlock. You stumble across three gyroscopes. I forgot to put a door here. I'm going to do that later. There should be a door right here. Right in between these blocks. Here we have the oxygen vent. There will be a second one over there. Gravity generator. Some gyros and a pair of nuclear reactors. Through this is the primary bridge. And it's really the only bridge. Good visibility and protection. Head through, and you see the back of the ship. You have the beacon, two cargo containers, the oxygen tank, six bunk beds. You see a medical facility, kitchen sink, oven, refrigerator, coffee, food, and up here, 1, 2, 3, and 4. These are control units for the turrets on the outside. 1 and 3 are here, 2 and 4 the other side. And as you can tell, there's a big nuclear reactor. On the other side of this wall is the primary thrusters for forward momentum.
I just came back. I've made a couple modifications I forgot. Actually working on it this time. So the Sparrow, here's the door I was talking about, and a couple little things. First off, there's a turret here, and there's the oxygen pressurizer. There's another oxygen vent back here. Now, from up front, you have direct control over the primary rocket pods. They shoot very rapidly and reload instantly, so it's a ton of damage. Now, there are cameras. This one, I'm not sure where. That's a dock camera. This is directly on top of the ship, or it should be. Doesn't look like it is. Where is this? Oh, yeah, it is. This is on top of the ship. Excuse me. That's on top of the ship. Right next to the connector, you have port camera, starboard camera. Those are by the oxygen vents, because that's the widest part of the ship. Rear cameras right in between the engines. Gear cameras right in between two of the engines. Now, there is something a little extra that I'll... So, one of the things you will note, not all the lights are on. Why? Well, this is an actual ship, and I took a page out of Star Trek. They have a red alert system. What happens when you go to red alert? The main lights should turn off, and the red lights turn on. Of course, the beacon stays on to keep this area kind of lit a little. And there's a single light right here that stays on, so you can have access to the gravity generator and that turret. Yeah, it doesn't interfere with the camera so much. So, there's even the one right there, just to let him know as well. Ha ha ha, that's true. So now, as you can see, there's a comparison there. There's reactors. The gyros, well, there's a couple of gyros there, yes, but the majority of the gyros are up here. As you can see, there's a fair amount of gyros here, along with cargo containers, but the gyros go to underneath as well. Hey, look at all those. There's quite a few gyros on this ship. And there's that big reactor. Phasing through the floor is always fun every now and then. Plenty of cargo space. It's a warship after all, and you're going to need fuel for that reactor. So, now button 2 only activates the cannons in case you're engaging a target. You just tap it and it auto fire. That way you can fire the rockets in conjunction with those cannons to really annoy someone. You just hit button 2 and it'll just automatically constantly fire. Now, one thing you can do, if you go to the rear of the ship, like I said, is take control of the turrets. Make sure to close the doors behind you, please. Now, position 1 takes control of the forward gun towards the front of the ship. Don't shoot your own ship, but it's a good old Gatling gun that does all it usually does. You can see there is gun 3, and over there is the other turret. Oop. Be careful of that. You might want to disable the gravity generator when you do that. Here's gun 2, the front on the starboard side, on the right. Gun 3, first off, you have control here. You can see there's the back of the ship. There's the front. Well, position 3, rather, has access to gun 3, which is here on the port. It's kind of topsy-turvy, but hit button 2, you have access to the gun position here
And that takes away the position from the... Well, it doesn't take it away. It gives it to you for you to use. And here's gun number 4. The same thing, just on the other side. And, yeah, you have access to this gun. Doing that will give Gatling turrets 3 and 4 back to the AI. Giving it to the AI will allow them to easily repair, and not repair, to repel things while your primary ship operator deals with the rockets, and you guys deal with those guns, and the AI takes over those. So now, what's this ship like in maneuverability? Well, since we get away from here, first off, maneuverability, yeah, it's there. Oh, I'm pushing this segment, and everything else. As you can see, maneuverability, it's quite extensive. Make sure you don't turn when you're doing that, okay? You'll shoot yourself. You can't turn at all when doing that. You can go up and down when you're shooting the rockets. Oh, you see those cannons shooting way out there. The rockets are not. The rockets keep shooting myself, really. The rockets are close range. These cannons are quite extended long range. You see them way out there. So, maneuverability, well, as it should be known by now, these things turn on a dime. And, you can see, although it lacks in the forward department, it's still pretty good for side to side. And reverse isn't that bad. Forward should be better than it is, but it's not terrible. It's alright, I suppose. Going up is actually not bad, and down also not too bad. There's 127 thrusters, 22 gyroscopes, 3 landing gear, 330 megawatts of power, and this thing weighs 1,209,478 kilos. This is a lot of weight. The SMDC Sparrow. First actual warship. This is a Corvette, by the way. The frigate will have some bigger guns. I'm not sure what, but I'm thinking I have a couple of ideas, but this is the Sparrow. Let's get rid of some of this junk lying around, including that one. But yeah, the IMDC, the Interplanetary Mining and Defense Corporation, is where I took the idea of this off of in the first place. The idea of having the SMDC. I don't get why people have only one or two gyros. That's what I just don't get. I'm going to show you this guy's ship. As you can see, he's got 4 turrets and a rocket launcher. But like I said, this ship's fat, but short. So short and stubby. Very open cockpit here. Timer block, don't know what that is. But very open cockpit with lots and lots of windows. My cockpit, as you can tell, not so open. It's still protruding out the front, but yeah, there's not quite so many windows. Reduced visibility, but definitely increase in damage. I mean, not damage, in protection. He's got 2 rocket launchers and 4 turrets. Now, those turrets are not automated. There's also appears to be a missing block here. Go to the other side of the ship. Although, I do like what he did with these. Having it come together like that, not bad at all. Yep, there's another missing block. He's got his short, stubby ship, but he could have used a couple more gyros. And this design for the design here for the cockpit, one rocket into a large area will knock out a bunch of glass and kill the operator. My ship, won't be so easy. I mean, you'll still kill them probably, but there's backup positions in the rear. So you head up here, you have the primary pilot's chair,
And he only has two gyros. It turns... it's okay. Going up. It's not very quick going up or down. There's not much thrusters for that. Forward thrust overloads the engines. I mean, not the engines, the reactor. And it is struggling to slow down. It is definitely struggling. This position is just a position to do something. It doesn't actually have much purpose. Turning his ship around is a pain. His ship cannot stop. The whole point of the SMDC is what sojourner means. It means to not stay in one spot for very long. So, you can see his guns activate and they just open fire and that's it. His rockets are further away so you don't blow your ship up, but they're simply push the button and start shooting. Same with his guns, by the way. You have to turn on the guns and start shooting. Now he has the ability to turn off his lights, but still. I'm sorry, the ships are slacking. It looks nice. It looks nice. Oxygen storage, okay. Doors, lights, gravity generator. Why would you want to generate? Okay. The doors? I turned off my inner damper. Those are the interior lights. Hit the doors button. Doesn't seem to do much. Unless there's supposed to be shutters or something. Missing. Nope, it does nothing. So you have this, which leads to the reactor room event in the air, nuclear reactors, and that's it. And there's your two gyros. The ship is quite compact, and I like that. The problem is... well, my ship can work with a one-man crew. His ship can work with a one-man crew. The problem is his ship cannot operate better by having a few more crew members. My ship does. My ships would all operate better with having more crew, but my early ships at least, not necessarily going to be the bigger ships, but definitely the earlier ships operate better. With, well, they can operate with one crew. Some of the big ships, like my heavy cruisers and battleships, definitely, probably won't be able to operate with a single crewman, but that doesn't, you know, they're battleships. They're big cruisers. What do you expect? So, yeah, that guy, I'm sorry, but he's got a few problems, I think. But that's where I got my idea to build the whole series of ships from. But today, we have the Sparrow, a Corvette. Enjoy.